Hi there. Today we're going to do some work to the Volvo. The Volvo is driving pretty good, but it tends to be a bit hard to start when it's cold outside, and sometimes I have some misfires. And I checked the ignition basics on it the other day, the plugs and wires and cap and everything. And they are extremely old. I took off the cap, and a lot of buildup was on the metal parts where the spark goes through. I scraped it off and cleaned it, but it was pitted and very badly damaged. We have some spark plugs. Spark plugs needs to be gapped at around 1.7 to 1.8. So you'll have to go about checking if that fits. It's tight on the 1.8 and it's loose on the 1.7. That means it's perfect, this one. But do check all of them, even though they have been pre-gapped, because you never know if it's right on. The wires. The rotor, because it was badly corroded out here, the other one. The rotor cap. This is where the spark goes from. It travels from the coil into this, and this one is turning around inside here, and when it goes past one of the posts down there, it sends a spark to the corresponding spark plug here and goes to the engine. What you have to be aware of when changing stuff like this is that you have to keep everything in order. It's a good idea to take a picture before taking stuff apart if you haven't tried it before, because if you get the wires mixed up, the timing will be completely off on your car and it will not work.
So we are inside the Volvo now. I have driven the car later earlier today, so I think it will be easy to start. But the problem is if it has been standing for a couple of days, you will have to crank it for quite a bit if it's cold. And that could be many things. It could be just because of the cold, and it could be the carb is not adjusted probably and everything. But it could also be that the spark is having a hard time reaching the spark plugs because of bad hardware. So that is where I'm going to start, also because I know the parts are bad. I know the rotor is bad and I know the cap is bad. It's worn out. The wires also, the plugs, I don't really know, but they seem old, so I'm just gonna change them. So let's see if it starts. Yeah, no problem, no problem. And I just want to say it again, it's not necessarily the plugs and wires that's the cause of hard starting issues. It's a common go-to, and almost every time you put a car to a garage and say and tell them it's hard to start, they will change that, and it's expensive, and many times it's not necessary. So don't just change them by default. Do a visual inspection at least to check if they are old or worn out. If the spark plug wires get very old, they get brittle, and then the spark can actually go through the rubber and short into some place else than the spark plug. So the spark is not getting into the engine, but it's just shorting out on the block or something like that. The spark will also choose the way of least resistance, and normally in a healthy system that will be into the spark plug. So that is what you want to try to retain. So yeah. Look at the metro. First, we're gonna pop off this. And then I'm gonna remove the one going to the clip, putting it in like so. I don't think the new one has that on. Hopefully it will fit anyway. Then we're going to take this off. And this is what, how you can check if these are okay. You can see down here that there is a lot of buildup on the posts. It's not looking that bad right now because I cleaned it off the other day, but it's actually worn away, the material, so the gap between has become bigger. So this is very worn. You have to keep the orientation so you know how it goes on. Right now I'm just going to put it in there. This one is taken off just by pulling it upwards. It sometimes takes a bit of force, like that. And this I also cleaned the other day, but now it's going to be changed. Always check if the parts look the same and are the same. Put this on. But it has a slot right there that goes into the hole right there. And then clamp it on. So now we're going to take one spark plug and one spark plug wire at a time to keep everything oriented. So this is the outer one. Pull it off. I need an extension for this one. Wow, that was extremely loose. Also, the engine is rocking quite a bit. I might have to check my engine mounts. The engine mounts are prone to wear out on these Volvos because of safety. They are designed to let the engine go underneath the car, not into the cabin. And a consequence for that is they deteriorate quite fast. Because that it is orientated like this, I will now remove all the spark plugs because I can look at this, where the different plugs go. So I will remove all of them. They're really loose, but they haven't been torqued to. That was completely loose. Wow. I wonder why the car actually was running as good as it was. This had a very bad connection, that's for sure. The misfire I talked about earlier most likely came from this one because it was so loose. See, now this is a problem. This one is black, this one is not. This one is actually... yeah, we are definitely not going to reuse them. But this indicates a lean burn on this one. Yeah, this car is not having a very even burn, that's for sure. Got two black ones and two white ones. That could indicate a problem in the gasket area, but let's not jump to conclusion. Could just be because it's just been fired up a couple of times with the choke on, and for some reason might the outer cylinders might get a bit more fuel than the other one. So that could explain why these are black, because this indicates too much fuel, which is normal when the choke is on, and this indicates a bit too little. This is one is actually almost close to perfect, but this one is a bit lean. Yeah. Sometimes it's better not knowing how the compression is. We'll take that another day. I maybe make a video on changing a head gasket if it comes to that. So let's get going. I've checked all the spark plug gaps and they are fine. So let's install these. Like that. Then you put on the first plug and get it on right, click it on, and then I know it's this one, so it'll follow that one and put the new one in like there. And then look at this one is the outer one right here, which is this one on the new one. Then the next one is actually the same procedure. And then you can take this one off and put this organizing thingy on. And put this one in so that it doesn't rub against anything if you can. Almost always feels a bit better when you have done something, but I think it feels a bit more smooth in the engine. And it wouldn't surprise me because it was worn out, that's for sure. It will be exciting to see if it starts better in the morning. That I'm looking forward to. But this is nice. It runs great. Yeah, the spark plugs did have some signs of engine issues, but as I said, it is signs, and it's not always that signs are telling the truth. It is just an indication, and there could be a lot of explanations as of why the outer spark plugs were black, overfueling, and the middle ones were white, underfueling, maybe. And it could be to do with the way the carb and inlet is set up, I think. But it could also be because the engine is worn. It could be because of carbon buildup, making the middle pistons maybe have a lot of carbon buildup, and that will affect the mixture. So that is also a possibility. And you could investigate and find out why, but the reality is that I will, if I found out that something was wrong with the engine, I would still just drive it until it exploded, and then I would change it or fix it or something like that. So that won't really change anything. Let's go home.